hearted man. Been a causing trouble ever since the world began. But don't you worry out ever since the world began. Well, a hard-headed woman is a thorn in the side of a man.
I really was not outrageous by any means, but my dress was different, and my singing these songs, which in the, like I said, very assertive music for them. And I think I was known as kind of a rebel. The cutest thing a guy wrote about me in the press, he said, he named all the songs I was doing, Mean Mean Man, Fujiyama Mama, Hot Dog That Made Him Mad. It said, but really, when you meet Wanda, said she's really a sweet lady with a nasty voice.
Wanda Jackson was born in Oklahoma during the Dust Bowl years. To escape this hardship, her father, like many other Okies before him, moved the family to Bakersfield, California. It was there that young Wanda was first dazzled by that city's burgeoning music scene.
And I remember seeing Rose Maddox and the Maddox Brothers.
Wild, wild young men like to have a good time. Wild, wild young men like to have a good time. Wild, wild boyfriends like to lose their mind.
I was so young, I was about 7 probably, and I can't remember exactly what was in my head, but I do remember thinking, oh, I've got to do that. She looked so pretty. She was, had all this sparkle stuff on and singing, and they were so energetic. I mean, that was, for those days, it was very unusual, and it just excited me. And I said, I've got to be able to do that. And so I learned all of her songs, and she was very instrumental in my career, my singing style, because I liked her feistiness.
Wanda had other musical influences as well. Her idol was Hank Thompson, who happened to hear her on a radio show in Oklahoma City and later invited her to play with him. Thompson helped Wanda get a record deal with Decca. She soon began touring in package shows with many of the male stars of the day.
They always had just one girl. And probably because there weren't that many girls, it seemed to be a man's field. And I never even thought about that when I entered it. You know, I just, hey, this is what I'm gonna do.
I love a mean, mean man who lives uptown. When I want him most, he's not around. He's a mean, mean man.
She played guitar and she danced, and she really had a good, I guess, rapport with the audience and things like that. She would talk to them, and some of the guys, she'd kind of flirt with them a little bit and shake and things. And she really made it a show.
I'm talking about you. He's a mean, mean man, but I love him all I can. Here we go now, yeah.
My daddy told me, he was never a star, but he did perform. He said, Wanda, if you have fun on stage, everybody else will. So I just had fun.
In 1956, Wanda was asked to perform at the Grand Ole Opry, the mother church of country music. But this was both an honor and a challenge, since the Opry only occasionally invited a rockabilly performer to appear.
Well, I was so thrilled about being invited to the Grand Ole Opry. I'd had a country song in the top 10 or something. So I designed a special dress, and it had a what we called a sweetheart neck. And Mother and I, when Daddy, he'd come in and he'd check the line here. And then when he'd leave, Mother'd say, how much you want me to take it down? I'd say, oh, about an inch. I was so happy she got it made, and I was backstage getting ready to go on, and I was on Ernest Tubbs' portion. So he came back, and he looked around, and I was the only one there, had my guitar on. He said, are you Wanda Jackson? I said, yes, sir. He said, okay, you're on next. I said, great, I'm ready. And he looked at me, and he said, "Well, honey, you can't go on stage at the Grand Ole Opry like that." And I said, "What do you mean?" He said, "Well, you can't show your shoulders." I said, "Well, it's the only dress I have." He said, "Well, you'll have to cover it up." Said, "You've got about 2 minutes." So I had worn, luckily, a pretty decent-looking leather jacket with the long fringe and on the arms. That's all I could do. I was in tears. Put that old coat on, put my guitar back on, went out there and tried to sing. But, you know, I was trying to cry and sing, and I was so upset.
Well, I thought that you was a woman. Know if our love's the real thing. Where is my wedding ring? Yeah, we
and I was so upset when I left. I ran out, I got Daddy. I said, "We're leaving here, I'm not ever coming back." It was a problem to be a girl rockabilly singer. And I can honestly say I never heard any of the comments, but the word gets back to you. And, you know, I just couldn't believe it. I'm thinking, hey, you love the music, and if you like my singing, why can't I do this? America just wasn't ready for it. And it's hard for people today to understand how new this was. And it was like a shock.